Hi, in this video, I will summarize our discussion about operational amplifier. So first thing, the symbol of a basic operational amplifier. Here the terminal 2 represents the inverting terminal and this is the non-inverting terminal. This is the output terminal and here we have plus V voltage supply and the minus voltage supply. And the characteristics of op-amp are, there are important 3 points. The open loop voltage gain is very high. For ideal op-amp, this will be infinite. And for a practical op-amp, this will be a high value. The input impedance will be again very high for every op-amp. And for a practical op-amp, this will be of the order of 10 raised to 5 ohm. And this will be infinite for an ideal op-amp. The output impedance is very low. For ideal op-amp, the output impedance is 0 ohm. Whereas for practical op-amp, the value will be less than 200. Oh, okay. Now, the inverting amplifier configuration. This is the circuit of an inverting amplifier configuration here. Sorry, non-inverting amplifier configuration. Here, the non-inverting terminal is, we will apply the signal to the non-inverting terminal. And the inverting terminal, we have an input resistance. The other end is grounded. And you have a feedback resistance from the output to this inverting terminal. Okay. Now, for a non-inverting amplifier, the closed loop gain ACL will be equal to 1 plus RF by RI. Okay. Now, the circuit diagram for a inverting amplifier. In the inverting amplifier case, the non-inverting terminal is grounded. And we have, in the inverting terminal, we will apply the input. And you have an RI and a feedback resistance. Okay. Then the equation for this case, the closed loop gain ACL will be equal to minus RF by RI. Now the negative sign represents that, this negative sign represents that this is inverting amplifier. Whereas in this equation, there is no negative sign. That means this is a non-inverting amplifier. Non-inverting means our signal, input signal and output signal will be in phase. Whereas in the inverting amplifier case, if you give an input signal like this, the output will be 180 degree phase. There will be 180 degree phase difference between the input and output. Okay. Now next is a summing amplifier. Now a summing amplifier is just a modification of inverting amplifier. These two are very similar. Instead of a single resistance, we are adding more than one resistances and more than one voltage sources. Here you will have V1, V2 and V3, three voltage sources in the circuit. So these are the three input voltages, V1, V2 and V3, and the output of this circuit will be equal to V out is equal to minus RF into V1 by R1 plus V2 by R2 plus V3 by R3. So this is the output expression for a summing amplifier. All these expression you have to remember in the examination point of view, because in order to solve the numerical problem, you have to remember this or you have to derive this equation. Okay. Now next circuit is a differentiator. Now in a differentiator, there is a capacitance in the input circuit and a resistance in the feedback network. Okay. Then the output of this differentiator will be equal to V out is equal to minus RC into dVi by dt. Then in order to construct the integrator, you have to shift the position of the capacitor, or you have to interchange the position of the capacitor and resistance. Here you need a resistance and here you need a capacitor. Then you will get an integrator. So this is the circuit. Okay. Now, the output expression for an integrator, V out will be equal to minus 1 by RC integral of time integral of VI into dt. So, the output expression is a integral of the input expression. Whereas in the case of differentiator, the output expression is a differential of the input voltage. Okay. So this slide summarizes all our discussion in our last few videos.